Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of Om, Blind, Enhanced Edition, stuff like that.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Okie dokie.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Still nothing in these. So, what is the Den of the Seven Veils? Shall we go in here? Your patrons, Atello di Bonito, peasants, commoners, and stares up.
Live by the sword, live a good long time.
There's a patron.
Is this important?
Buy me an ally. Not buying you anything.
You certainly aren't from around here, are you?
No, I'm not. My daughter just got married to a fisherman. I think she could have done far better. My wife says that Letanan runs himself a house of grinders, but what does she know?
You look like a good enough sort.
My sister was fleeced only a few minutes after leaving her home yesterday. What is the city coming to? It's coming to horror. Unbridled horror. Don't be going into the slums now, I warn you. If you look like you could run more than two coppers together, you'll be jumped in no time. Did I talk to him? I think so. I wonder when the Shadow Thieves are going to nip those fools who are running against them. It'll happen. You watch. Alright, let's talk to Alatello di Bonito.
Hello there.
Hello, hello. Welcome to... what time is it? It's morning. Then welcome to the morning showing of the talents of Alatello di Bonito. A rousing wave of indifference from the crowd yet again. Ah, well. If I let such things bother me, I would have given up the stage years ago. As per the wishes of most of my audience, unfortunately, at least the occasional dwarf applauds. Well, doesn't swear and leave, anyway. Let's see. A tale of familial woe to tantalize your tears and tempt your time and interest. Alright, is he singing or reciting poetry? Raised of spells and casting well, but always wanting better. To sing of nights and days of yore, to leave the robes that fetter. A wizard prone to song and prose, though oft accused of failing. I shall sing despite the odds. Patricia says, will you shut your bloody wailing? Excellent. That just completely rhymes. Thanks for Patricia. Well, finish, Mrs. Patricia. You've a fine ear for rhyme, though. I would hope you'd be more supporting of your own employees. I support you sticking to spells and figures. You're a security and a financial advisor, not the entertainment. Hit the road if you want a forum for your singing. Also, he was singing. Very well, Mrs. Patricia. Thank you for your indulgence thus far. No, it was over here.
Have you ever heard of my people, the Avariel?
The winged elves? Very little. I thought they were all gone. Most of us were, according to what I remember my mother telling me, killed by the dragons before the first flowering, but some of us still survive in isolated places. Well, I'm glad you're still alive. My own people live high in the mountains to the far south, in a place called Fania Dale, separated from conflict with others. It was a grand and majestic place. My memory is dim, but whenever the thought of it crosses my mind, my eyes still blur with tears. Tell me more about your people, Aerie. Our homes were open places of marble pillars and vistas from which you could watch the entire mountain range below. There was no place you could not spread your wings. We cherished the wind and the rains. We breathed in life, Sapphire, and lived in peace with each other. There were distinct societies among us, as I remember. There were great aerial warriors who defended us, possessing class weapons that radiated in the sunlight. And my own class pursued art and knowledge, building the great buildings and filling them with glorious wonders. It was... I am sorry, Sapphire. I can speak of it no longer. I am suddenly homesick, silly as that seems. I miss so much, it makes me ache. I suppose I must seem very foolish to you. Not at all. Stand back.
In the name of the council,
Always
I am
drunk.
Here to keep order.
I am the law. I think.
Top of the day to you.
You aren't planning on joining the army. Coward. I'm here and eager to sign up. Alright. Can we just walk back here? Oh, is this the... Well, there's no one in here.
I am ready, I think.
I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
All empty. That's it, okay. Please don't come and attack us.
You point! Stand back! For justice!
Oh, don't hit that. I don't want to hit the counter. Alright, there is an upstairs. Which I almost forgot about. There's a smell of orc slicer up here.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
Me timber's bad enough without ye bothering me.
Menkar Pebble Crusher says, Ha! If I didn't be a puny half-elf, dressed up as a mighty adventurer, I'd say. Ha ha! Did your mama let you out from under her skirt, little one? Best you be running back now. Smaylov says, Ha! Hick! That be a good jest, Menkar, my friend. Ha! Pookie looks like a mephit or a tiny dragon or wyvern. Says, A good jest, says Smelly. A good jest, he says. Smaylove says, Amon, you tell your stinking fart-smelling imp to stop calling me Smelly. The name be Smaylove Orcslicer. If he does say it again, I'll smash him into impish goo. Well, now we know it's an imp. Papa, Papa, Smelly is threatening me again. He is threatening. Amon of the Purple Brotherhood. How many people are in here? Or beings? Says, Calm yourself, Pookie. As for you, you barbarian knucklehead. Threaten my familiar once again, and you'll spend the rest of an evening as a toad. Am I understood? So it's his familiar. Smaylove says, What? You dare besmirch the honor of Smaylove Orcslicer? I will... Menkar says, Enough, blast it! I tire of your bickering. Now, as for you, little half-elf, you'd best take yourself somewhere where you're more welcome. This bar be big enough only for us, and no more. Oh, he's talking to me now. Okay. How about I buy you a drink? There's no need for us to be on such harsh terms. You can take your drink and shove it where the sun won't be shining, you blasted lily half-elf. I'll not associate with a quibbling weakling in my own bar, so be off with you. Smaylove says, Ha! You is so funny, Menkar. Smaylove laughs heartily at your insulting manner. Brennan Rizzling says, Really, Menkar? Is all this necessary? Must you agitate everyone who comes into this bar? Blasted right I must. We be celebrating, Brennan, and I'll be damned if I'm going to drink while the odor of yon half-elf offends me nostrils. Now be off, half-elf, before you have a taste of me axe. Fine, I'll leave you and your group alone. Ha! Off you go then, cur. Hang your tail twixt your legs and scurry off like the cowardly dog that you are. Ha ha. Okay, I don't like that very much.
Swords! Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
What's his problem?
What you want?
Be gone. Hip!
Smell of Orcslicer be gorging himself mightily on meat and ale, cannot be bothered by talk. Hip!
So there's Brennan.
Hi, friend.
I would apologize for my comrades, but they represent a great profit for me and my thiefly abilities. It would be better if you left, I suppose. Menkar is always serious with his threats. So there's Menkar. What about Pookie, though? Hee hee hee, I stole something from Smelly, I did. Smelov says, what? What did you steal from Smelov, devilish imp? Pookie stole Smelly's brains while he's sleeping. Hee hee, Smelly won't miss him. Blast you, imp. I shall grind you into powder if you continue these taunts. And my name is Smelly... Smelov. Ah!
This will be a slow and painful process.
You'd best be on your way, as Menkar suggests. I am Sorceress Imoen of the Purple Brotherhood, and I stand behind my dwarven comrade, and I am not to be treated lightly. Alright, let's go. I don't want us to get in trouble. We have to use magic, and then we get apprehended.
Bat kicking, for goodness!
Maybe we'll run into them later. Galoomp, the bookkeeper.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Oh, he's a bookkeeper.
Welcome to my humble establishment.
Right jolly day, eh, sir? You be wanting to take a gander at me bookies and scrolls? Bookies, I like it. I would indeed. Lots of spells, that's for sure. What books? All you have is scrolls. Hess? Just pushing her along.
What do you need?
Well, meet a foot and all
you
that.
You look like the sort who has more than two gold pieces to rub together.
A good business to you, my lord. I do not recognize you, I think. Would it be impertinent for Hess to inquire as to your name? Not at all. I am Yoshimo. Well met, Yoshimo, and a pearl to you. Feel free to peruse my goods and ask questions naturally. That's interesting how they keep talking about pearls. A pearl to you. A pearl sent me. Let's ask other things. Perhaps you can tell me where I could find a suitable inn. I do not know if I would call it suitable, but you could certainly look to the copper coronet in the slums. It is better than ore on credit, as they say. Could you perhaps direct me to a temple or such where I might receive healing? Yeah, right down there. There are several places of worship that could assist you in the temple district, my friend. A shrine to Ilmater is also close by, if you wish. Yeah, it's like this, I think. I'm looking for quality goods, perhaps magical items and such. I have little taste for magic, but sometimes an item of that nature comes into my possession. You could try the adventurer mart for such things. I see. Well, let me see what services you have. As you wish. Unfortunately, my stock is not what it once was, with the troubles of late, but it is still a good selection. Alright, we've got some antidotes. But I have very little money. Wait, I don't want these bolts plus one. And we don't need the small shield, since that doesn't really help. Our money situation. Because I don't want to get rid of these other things. I'll get rid of these. That's better. Get some money there. It was only three. Okay. So wait, that's the... Elixir of Health. That cures. Maybe just one. He's got an Elixir of Health as well. She has hers as well. The rest to old Minsky here.
Are you a thief and a scoundrel and a scurvy cowardly knave?
That's all?
That's the most ridiculous offer I've ever heard.
I could give 3 nights for that.
Have a look at my wares. I trust you'll find them all in satisfactory condition.
Foreclosing on me so soon? Oh, very well. You're welcome to my humble shop at any time, however. Good to know. So noisy when those things open. Look like a wood pile.
Additional potions, extracts, and oil.
Minsk, and jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Well, if you don't want it, sir, I have plenty of people who want it, you know.
Kendall, we have weapons, sir.
I should surprise these things are still here. Alright, we can't get in there. He won't let us. There's Mira. Alright, I do want to check out the ore merchant. Oh, there's a district exit there as well. Tunnel out of Promenade. Cool. Let's see if the ore merchant is here. I mean, I don't need any ore, but he might have something interesting to say. Town crier.
Hear ye, hear ye!
She's a scorcher this morn. A dozen Karaks hit the high seas from Mastika. Waterdeep and New Am showdown for resources. What of Mastika? Tell me more, crier. Helmsport is the apple of New Am's eye. Enter Waterdeep. Seeking to expand her influence and ruthlessly plunder under the guise of diplomacy. The Council of Six send an armada of Helm priests and sellswords to expel the Waterdeepian traitors before the natives sniff the winds of change. The Seven Heavens forbid if metal or magic should fall into the wrong hands in the colonies. Trouble is a-brewing, gathered friends. Count on it. You heard it here first. Bad news travels fast, and misfortune spreads like wildfire. Your humble servant reads from the true book, bringing latest news of the realms. Yeah, extremely humble, I can tell.
Have a look at my wares. I trust you'll find them all in satisfaction.
Okay, how do I get up back up here?
I've got a spell to make the ladies love ya! Right up here!
Jerlia, the ore merchant.
Anything you need, I can likely provide.
Greetings, good customer. What you say? To you.
Get on with you. I don't deal with individuals. Bulk ore is what I sells. You need a few pebbles, you go scrounge it yourself. For this, we came all this way?
Every, the bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Just checking to see if anyone would be at these other stalls and... Not really.
Armor, live by the sword. Live a good long time.
All right. We advance this way.
Step right up.
Come, enter the adventurer mart. Behind me, you will find all the equipment any adventurer needs. Weapons both magical and plain, stolen armor from the lairs of dragons, scrolls of sorcery, anything you need, we have. Not everything. Well, Mrs. Harold. I'm gonna talk to Harold.
And who might you be?
I think what you've done is so heroic.
Is this important?
We're mighty grateful for everything you've done, my lord. Mrs. Harold says, yes, now our trip won't have been a waste at all. Oh, that's good to know.
Well, this one won't be tall enough to... For sure, you'll never be tall enough to...
Minerals, sir! Quartz,
the
rigia! Oh,
let's take a look back here. There's probably nothing, but we'll see. I'm thinking there might be a way into these buildings here, but it doesn't seem to be.
What do you think? I'm in business for me life, for me out, sir? I wouldn't lie to you, sir.
This potion is vectors. I want the money back.
I've got spells to bring your family. Good luck!
You really hear what they say, with the music off like that. It's not but a piece of stone. Here's a radial. The real radial.
Yes?
Eh? Please be excusing me. This common tongue of yours is being very difficult for me. Okay then. That's it for that, behind the Colosseum building. It's not worth the table it's sitting on. Who's a dog? I heard a dog. Oh, that's interesting.
This is the land
of secret incantation,
a veritable paradise for those with coin.
Well, it's her talking.
Kendall? I tried this spell on my wife. She kicked me out of the house.
What's this? We couldn't get in there because there was a bodyguard there. He's probably still there. We just can't see him from where we are. Not only a thief, but a scoundrel as well.
Sir, you look like a man who needs a good spell of his wife.
Can't get up here to map out the land. We have knives, sir? Is that what he said?
Come, sir, buy my iridium!
So the spell store? I talked to him, right? Here's the guy up here, yeah. He didn't have much for us.
Sir, you look like a man who needs a good spell over his wife.
A good spell for his wife? That doesn't sound like a good idea.
I've got a spell to make the ladies love you! Right up here!
For the glory of Arm!
There's a spell to make the ladies love you, and then a spell to get rid of your wife. Seems to be a certain order you can cast those spells in. What are they gonna do with the snake, the moose, and the leopard?
Oh,
Alright, I think we're done with this section. This kind of bothers me here, but I don't think we can get up in there. You need to look for the government section. Government district. A scurvy, cowardly knave.
Additional potions, extracts, and oil!
So... unreachable from where we are. Is that where we are now? The slums? Oh no, we're at Waukeen's Promenade. We can only go to the slums from here. Alright, let's go to the slums. Oh, we hit travel?
Cool! You'd be the one I'd be looking for, if I'm not to be mistaken.
Sapphire be your name, I? Why is he cooing like a bird? Well, I'm afraid you're mistaken.
That's so. I was thinking me sources of information infallible. Well, I suppose you won't be wanting any information on the young woman arrested by the cowled wizards when you first came to Athkatla, huh?
You're speaking of Imoen? What do you know of her?
Aha! So I does have you correctly. Cool! And here I thought I'd be talking to a complete stranger. Wiping me brow, I am.
and cooing.
Now, Imoen, hey, that be her name.
Yep.
Young lass made the misfortune of casting a spell or two in a city that frowns on such business. Bad timing it was. You be thinking you wants to find her, then?
Of course I want to find her. What do you know?
Cool! I knows very little myself.
Milady, I can, however, link you up with a group that knows. Or can be finding out.
But this be not the best place to hold such a dialogue. I be having a place that would suit far better. It be just a short walk from here.
I don't know if I should trust this guy.
Why don't I take you there right now? Unless you have some reason for not wanting to come along.
How do I know this isn't some kind of trap?
I have no interest in setting up a trap.
It'd be more profitable to serve. I'll speak no more. Come with me and you can decide whether to enter me house. Okay. Oh, I guess we decided to enter the
house. It's good to be seeing you once again.
Milady, I see that you were able to keep up with me all right, eh? I was afraid I'd lost you there, heh. Okay, well, we were supposed to follow him and then decide whether to enter his house. But ta-da, here we are. I find where I need to be just fine. Have you something to say to me or not?
Aye, I'll be doing that as quick as you blink. I'll tell you straight that I know a powerful group that can be helping you. They can be finding the wizard and the young woman both they can. But they can be doing far better than the telling, my friend. They can also effect a rescue of your lass to boot.
I don't know if we should seem that eager. Just what is this organization anyway? This I cannot tell ya. Rest you fine that they be willing to help and having enough power to challenge the cowled wizards, that all you be needin' to know. I see. And how much might such assistance cost me? It may seem to be costly, but think of the danger in crossing the cowled wizards. A fair price, if you think about it. It be 20,000 gold pieces for their help. I definitely don't have that. I don't have that much money. How am I supposed to raise such a fare? I am sure you have spent as much in the past and will again. Surely there be work in the city for you, or perhaps some of your expensive goods to sell? I'm just curious what he might say. Where can I sell some goods? Coo! Whatever he is, I don't know why he does that. There be many places to sell as well as buy. Our Ledrian upstairs is as good as any. He may have a few items you need as well, I think. Is there no help to be found elsewhere? There be no aid elsewhere. Raise the coin or nay, you'll come back, and I'll be waiting. You may want to speak with Eledrian upstairs to help you out. Good luck. Bruss will be waiting for you outside. He's me nephew, and he'll show you to the copper coronet. You'll find work easily enough there, you will. There was some fellow named Medine looking for adventurers. Don't know much about him, but he's at the government district if you're interested. Medine. Fare you well, then, and give me greetings to Letinan if you happens by him. Heh. Who's that? Oh, wait.
The deal is made, and you have a goal, albeit a distant one. Your new friend has assured you that passage to Imoen can be bought, though you are certain the final tally will include much more than gold. Any help is welcome, however, and while the cost may be steep, your path is clear. Finding Imoen will lead to Irenicus, and to answers long overdue.
Okay, so it's Irenicus, apparently, not Irenicus. Well, are these the cowled wizards?
These are the prisoners from the disturbance at Joaquin's promenade.
Oh, there she
what
is.
Known.
And him.
Not but their names. The mage is John Irenicus.
Oh, he's
the girl
Irenicus.
Is Imoen.
I didn't do anything. He did it all. I had...
Silence, child. Allow the fool to make his judgment.
Why was Shut this man not gagged? Did he not slay four of you?
We dared not approach.
Regardless, in the end, he came willingly.
What should be done with them, sir?
They are deviants. Let them rot in Spellhold.
Spellhold. We gotta catch up with these people and find out where Spellhold is. Collect the fee for Gaelan Bayle. In the Athcatla slums I met Gaelan Bayle, who seemed to know something about Imoen's capture. He has led me to his home in the far eastern side of the slums district and bade me to enter, where we might discuss an offer of aid. Gaelan Bayle will connect me with a group who will aid in finding Imoen, but the price is 20,000 gold pieces. A steep cost, but he did mention that it entailed crossing the cowled wizards, not something to be done lightly. Once I have the 20,000 gold pieces, I am to speak with him again. All right, well, I think we're going to go speak to the cowled wizards before we have this gold, as it is. Okay, we got quests. We got the quests. This is new. I escaped from the mad maze that was... So the announcer said Irenicus. But this guy here, Bayle, said Irenicus. Oh no, not Bayle. One of the cowled wizards said that. So I'll say Irenicus, because I've been saying Irenicus. So his name, we found out, is John Irenicus. I escaped from the mad maze that was Irenicus' dungeon, only to encounter the wizard himself in a battle with assassins in black leather. Perhaps that was why I was able to escape as easily as I did. I do not know. Yeah, black leather. The assassins seemed to be blaming the mage for something, to which Irenicus responded with anger and powerful magic. Indeed, part of the structure that surrounded him had collapsed from the might of his spells. As the battle ended, however, Imoen attacked Irenicus herself, and when strange wizards appeared to put an end to the magical conflict, they took both Imoen and Irenicus away. I am left in the city of Athcatlan Am with few allies and enemies that I know nothing about. Imoen is missing, and the only place I can go to achieve answers is likely the same place she has been taken. I have encountered a man named Gaelan Bayle, who mysteriously seems to know who I am, and sought me out. He has an offer of aid from an equally mysterious source, and one which comes with a very high price indeed. Yep, just read that. Okay. So stay tuned for next episode, and we talk to Gaelan Bayle some more and see what this stuff is, see who's upstairs. He said we should go upstairs to get some help, I guess, selling things. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.